bienvenidos y bienvenidas a un nuevo vídeo del canal. Estamos aquí con un nuevo directo de Honkai y Star Rail. Me lo habéis pedido mucho ya aquí, estamos. Y bueno, hay muchísimas cosas que hacer, pero voy un poquito a explicaros lo más básico que tenemos ahora mismo, ¿vale? Una de estas bonitas cosas, como ya sabéis, tenemos una nueva aventura, ¿vale? Con todo esto de trazar caminos y la magia de la amistad. Tenemos la demostración del nuevo personaje Jiao Qiu. Tenemos aquí todavía esta misión de acompañante, que es lo que vamos a hacer en el vídeo de hoy y demás, pero bueno, vamos a decir un poquito. Una delegación de otro mundo devuelve una espada de Shenzhen de largo tiempo perdida y te invita a participar en la ceremonia de entrega. Pues vamos a darle a participar, vamos a venir por aquí. Esta misión, ya sabéis que lo único que hice fue acercarme al entrenamiento y me salió como un aviso de que me reuniera con Yun Li en el Callejón Aurum. Lo pudisteis ver en el anterior vídeo, en el del evento, ¿vale? O sea, no hemos hecho nada de la misión, pero bueno, ahí empieza, ¿vale? Así que espadas en alados, vida infinita, here we go. Vamos allá. Vamos a venir por aquí y vamos a ver de qué va esta misión de acompañante de nuestra querida Yun Li. Un personaje que la verdad que me he conseguido sacar, lo habréis visto antes de este vídeo, obviamente. Pero bueno, vamos ahora a darle aquí y a ver qué pasa.
There you are.
Dice, ¿aquí estás? Pues sí, aquí estoy, Yun Li.
I was looking around before you got here. I already looked everywhere, but March 7th is nowhere to be found.
Entonces, ¿ya no tenemos que buscarla?
Nope. Let's just assume she successfully skipped class. Actually, she's been quite diligent in her swordplay practice and hasn't taken many breaks lately. I think she deserves a day off. Besides, I used to skip classes even more than her back when I was still learning. If I was in the mood, I could train for 3 days straight.
Vaya.
But if I wasn't in the mood, none of my seniors could find me. So, I can understand where she's coming from.
Vale, entonces puedo irme.
No need. I asked you to come, so I won't send you away empty-handed. Since you're here, let me treat you to some tasty food. I'm more interested in you today.
Vale. ¿Yo? ¿Qué te interesa?
Let's walk and talk.
Bueno, pues vamos a aceptar la invitación de nuestra amiga. Volvemos al Callejón Aurum, evento que os recomiendo que completéis antes de esta misión para que veáis todo esto en su esplendor. Y bueno, vamos a ver qué pasa por aquí. Mesa para dos.
All right, come on in. What would you like?
Well, we'll have one of everything on the menu.
The entire menu?
Do you think it'll be enough?
Le preocupa que no podamos acabarnos todo.
Oh, don't worry. There are two of us.
Well, then I'll start making a few dishes, and if you need more, just let me know.
Thank you.
¿Estás segura? ¿Dijiste que estabas interesada en mí?
Well, to be more precise, I'm interested in your sword. Yan Qing mentioned you before. He said that you're not to be underestimated, and that your weapon has a unique shape. So, I've always been curious about your sword. How the weight is distributed, what material it's made of, whether it contains any special ingenia, and what kind of sword techniques you use.
No es una espada, es un bate de béisbol.
Seriously? A bat?
¿Aún sientes curiosidad?
Yeah, now more than ever. So, it really is a baseball bat. Grandpa said that a sword doesn't have to be constrained by its shape. So, in a sense, your bat is a sword too. He also said that a weapon mimics its master. So, your bat actually reflects your habits and nature, you know?
Vale.
Let me guess. You're someone who doesn't follow the rules, enjoys improvising, can handle yourself well against tough foes. Am I right?
¿Me has estado grabando en secreto?
Amazing, right? And I bet you owe always say something silly, like, rules are made to be broken. I've come across so many sword wielders.
Las reglas están para romperlas, no digo más.
Moral, but we're really just liars. Their swords always told the truth, though. They told me that their wielders were just a bunch of frauds who relied on their divine weapons for everything. I've hunted down hundreds of swords like this so far, and every single one of them has been melted down.
Espera, ¿tomas las espadas de las personas a la fuerza y las fundes?
Yes.
¿Qué dices?
Only for those who cross the line. Melting their swords is my way of protecting those weapons. But just looking at a sword is not enough. Grandpa always says, words and expressions can be deceiving, but in a fight to the death, a sword's movements never lie. The war dance is just around the corner. You'll be participating, right?
Miss Yun Li, for talented sword masters like you, the war dance is a perfect opportunity to show off your skills and make a name for yourself. But for people like him, who have already made significant contributions to the Xianzhou, they maybe don't need to prove themselves on the war dance stage. It has been a while, Mr. Nameless.
And you are?
Es la secretaria de la señora Yukong.
Thank you for your introduction, Mr. Nameless. I'm Shi Kuei, and I work in the Palace of Astrum as the secretary for the Hellmaster. I apologize for interrupting your conversation. I happened to hear you discussing the war dance. And since this person is an old acquaintance, I thought I'd come and say hello.
¿Vas a hospedar a alguien, Shi Kuei?
Yes, with the war dance approaching, many guests from afar are pouring in. Mr. Pavo here is one of them. He's from the distant planet Kalevala. Mr. Pavo's planet recently joined the Pan-Cosmic Trade System. He brought his delegation here this time, not only for business, but also to return something that belongs to the Xianzhou.
Miss Shi Kuei, the word gift is perhaps more fitting than return. While it did once belong to the Xianzhou, we faced many tribulations to be able to deliver it here, so it should be considered a gift.
I apologize for my poor choice of words. Mr. Pavo's delegation brought a legendary Xianzhou sword that had been lost for centuries. General Huayan plans to personally thank them at the Palace of Astrum and present the sword as a prize to the champion of the war dance. Mr. Pavo and I were actually on our way there. Since you two were talking so enthusiastically about the war dance, maybe you'd be interested in joining us at the Palace of Astrum?
Vale, pues vamos a hablar con Pavo, a ver qué pasa. Hola. ¿Pavo? Cuéntame cositas.
Nice to meet you both. The journey to the Xianzhou Lafu wasn't an easy one. But the scenery here is worth it. It's completely different from my homeland. Once the formalities at the Palace of Astrum are finished, I'll find a quiet spot on this street and plant a seedling. And then my mission will be complete. The Sword of Heroes will finally be returned to its rightful owners. I couldn't be happier.
Hablemos de Kalevala.
Oh, you're interested in my home planet? That's great. Your Excellency is welcome to visit us at any time. Even though the trade route just opened, it still might take around 200 system hours to get there from Pier Point. But our planet is really great. Yeah, sure, it's a bit cold and the food is a bit repetitive and our houses aren't as fancy as those on Pier Point, but that doesn't matter. We've discovered massive supernium deposits and we're on the path to prosperity.
También seré testigo de su regreso.
Wonderful. It's an honor to have so many people witness the sword's homecoming.
Vamos a hablar con Yun Li, a ver qué nos cuenta.
Let's head to the Palace of Astrum together.
Vale, para ser sincero, no me interesa la espada.
But I am. It's the prize for the war dance, after all. I might not know all the stories and legends, but I know a legendary sword when I see one. Grandpa always asks me to go look at swords with him, but he hasn't said anything about this one. It's really weird. But now that we're invited, let's go and check it out.
Vale. Hay que ir al palacio, así que vamos a hacer TP aquí. ¿Y qué queréis que os diga? Me está pareciendo bastante interesante el cómo empieza esta misión aquí de Yun-Li. Y bueno, vamos a seguir conociendo un poquito más de esta historia, a ver qué pasa. Vamos ahora a Espada Senara 2, Yun-Li. Cuéntame.
There you are. Come on. Let's go to the ceremony together.
¡Vamos! Ojo, Argenti.
Please allow me to offer a sincere compliment, my fair lady. Your beauty is as pure as a snow-white iris. Well, if it isn't my dear friend, glad to meet you again.
Who is this weirdo? Who is this knight?
I am Argenti, a member of the Knights of Beauty. I was invited as a part of the Kalevala delegation to escort the legendary Mieka Kivesa back to the Sienjo. May I have the honor of knowing your name?
My name is Yun-Li.
What a beautiful name. I wonder if you have ever heard the holy name of the pure and flawless goddess Adrilla.
Oh, you're here, Yun-Li. Didn't expect you to be so well informed. Well, now that you're here, don't forget your manners.
Manners, manners. Come on. You won't find another granddaughter as polite and well-behaved as me.
Well, just remember this is a very serious ceremony. Sorry for keeping you waiting, Mr. Pavo. Now, let the sword-gifting ceremony begin.
Before the ceremony officially commences, I want to express my gratitude to the Knight Argenti. Thank you for enlightening us about the sword's origin and for escorting it here safely so that we may complete this ceremony. On behalf of the Kalevalan delegation, I, Pavu Kalestaya, am here to return the legendary Mieka Kifesa to the Sienjo Alliance. Its rightful homeland.
I'm truly grateful for Kalevala's noble act of returning the sword and for the Knight of Beauty's chivalry. Now, as we gather here on the Sienjo Lafu, I officially welcome the sword back to its homeland. Mieka Kivesa. It's a fitting name for a sword with such a legendary past. I still remember the name engraved on this sword the day it was forged. Guyin. It was forged by Hong Guang, a craftsman from the Zhu Ming's Pyrogyre Forge.
Wait. Hong Guang?
Although its blade is worn and cracked, its essence remains as resilient as the Sienjo Cloud Knights. All it needs is some repairs and polishing. The skilled craftsman of the Artisanship Commission to regain its former glory. I've decided to entrust this sword, Guyin, to the Lawfu Artisanship Commission for restoration. Furthermore, it will serve as the prize for the champion of the Lawfu War Dance. This sword will be wielded against abominations to protect our homeland and live up to the mission of the Kalevalan delegation that returned it from so far away.
Thank you, General. It is an honor for Kalevala.
Now, esteemed knight and delegation members, please head to the Artisanship Commission, where...
No! This sword was forged by Hong Guang.
Yun-Li! these esteemed guests have brought back your father's last work. Where are your manners?
Oh, I didn't realize this sword was actually forged by your father. Returning it to its rightful owner is,
Grandpa, give me that cursed sword right now! I'll melt away the remnants of that man's curse once and for all!
¿Una espada maldita?
Don't be rude, Yumi. Apologize to our esteemed guests from afar.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry for making a scene. But I have to melt down this cursed sword. I won't let it fall into anyone else's hands.
Yunli, please.
Le dice que se vaya, ¿por qué? ¿Qué me estás contando? ¿Cómo le dice que se vaya y ya está?
This is exactly why I didn't want Yunli to know about this. I didn't want to create trouble, but trouble found its way here anyway. Perhaps it really is divine intervention. Could you please keep an eye on Yunli for me?
Por supuesto, me aseguré de que no se meta en problemas. Vamos allá.
That is a tall order, but I'm counting on you.
Bien, cuenta conmigo.
I apologize for the unfortunate interruption. Let us move on with the ceremony.
Pues nada, sigamos con la ceremonia, gente. Ya sabéis, esto es un no parar.
Unless I'm mistaken, Yunli should be around here somewhere.
Vale, hay que buscarla, ¿no? Vamos a buscarla fuera del palacio y a ver un poquito qué conseguimos encontrar. Yunli, ¿qué pasa? No llores. ¿Qué pasa, Yunli?
Did Grandpa send you to look for me? I bet he did.
De hecho, estoy aquí porque me importas.
Thank you.
Bueno, nos ha dado las gracias.
Just so you know, I'm here just waiting for the perfect moment to snatch that sword. And once I have it, I'll melt it down before anyone can react. Don't even think about stopping me. No one can stop me.
Vale, entiendo que nadie puede ayudarte si no explicas lo que está pasando. Vamos a intentar llegarle por ahí.
Surely he doesn't want you to help me. Have you heard of cursed swords? That sword is one.
¿Esa es una espada que fue maldecida?
I guess that's what it means. A cursed sword lets anyone, even a complete novice, wield it with insane skill. Just by holding the hilt, even the weakest rookie can brandish it with incredible speed and strength.
Con algo como eso, 7 de marzo podría graduarse en un solo día.
I'm not joking around.
Ya lo sé, pero yo lo intento.
I'm not making up some crazy story. While a cursed sword grants instant abilities to its wielder, it comes at a cost. It's like continuously adding fuel to the forge. With each swing, the sword drains the wielder's blood and essence. Day by day, the fuel will run out, leaving nothing but an empty husk. Soon enough, it will no longer be a person wielding a sword, but a mindless, killing machine, consumed by bloodlust and murderous thoughts.
Esto me suena extrañamente familiar.
I wonder if you've ever heard of a creature.
Heliobus, vaya, no hemos oído hablar de ello, venga.
It loves to feed on human emotions and memories, and excels at manipulating its hosts. There was
a lunatic swordsmith who infused metal blades with heliobi, as he was obsessed with turning weapons into living things. And this is how cursed swords were made.
Entonces, Guyun es una de esas espadas malditas.
I know. I shouldn't have caused a scene at the sword gifting ceremony. But I've thought this through. If I don't make a fuss now, that cursed sword will cause a whole lot more trouble. So it's better if it's me causing the trouble. By the way, aren't they supposed to be taking the sword to the Artisanship Commission for repairs? Why haven't they come out yet? Any ideas?
Puede que haya otras formas de salir del Palacio Astro. Eso ha sonado a... Paso de ti.
I'll just head straight to the Artisanship Commission. It doesn't matter why Grandpa chose that sword. I won't let it fall into anyone else's hands. I'll track down every single sword he forged and melt them down one after another. Just like I've been doing all these years. I have to go now.
Is she planning to sneak into the Artisanship Commission and steal that sword?
Algo me dice que es lo que planea precisamente. Así que vamos a la comisión, ya sabéis cómo va esto. Hacemos TP y vamos a investigar un poquito. Me está pareciendo súper interesante esto, ¿eh? Vale, vamos a preguntarle aquí a estos cracks. Hola.
Just a while ago, a girl came up to me, all fierce and demanding.
No idea who she is.
¿Llevaba una enorme espada?
She wasn't big at all. That weapon of hers was pretty intimidating.
Vale.
She was in a hurry, heading straight for the Artisanship Commission.
She said something like, "I'm a member of the Artisanship Commission."
Va directa a la boca del lobo, creo, ¿eh?
I got scared and pointed her toward Master Gongshu's warehouse, where he stores his automatons.
Wait, why did you give her directions? What if she's planning to steal something?
Vayamos al grano, ¿a dónde ha ido? Vamos a ver si nos dicen algo importante porque... Vaya tela, ¿eh? O sea, te dejan ahí con la intriga, pero soluciones ninguna. Vale, entonces hay que encontrarla en el almacén de arúmatas. Eso está un poco lejos, ¿no? A ver... Ahí no tengo el TP al lado, vamos allá. Vale. Vaya, aurómatas.
What are you doing here? Look, if I get into trouble, it's my problem. I don't want to drag you into it.
En serio, es momento de hablar de eso.
Let's smash these metal cans first. Then...
Vale, eso me gusta. Reventamos a los enemigos y luego ya si eso hablamos.
Come on, let's do this.
Momentazo. Pues nada, vamos a ver qué pasa con esto. Ya sabéis, ¡bot! ¡El disparo primero! Vale, este se cabrea.
Tedious.
Let's go.
All will be revealed.
Todo será revelado.
There's no reason with those with the low.
¡Eh, un cowboy! ¡Bomba!
Ready for death.
Rules are made to be broken.
Las reglas, esto lo rompe. Ahí está. Boom. Vamos a acabar con estos enemigos rapidito. Bomba. Van a por Budgil, ojo, siempre van a por nuestro amiguito, vale. Vale, se han hecho retribución, pero no pasa nada. Disparito a este, fuera. Curamos a todo el equipo. Y vamos allá. Me lo estoy pasando muy bien, por lo que os digo. Tenía muchísimas ganas de ver cómo iba continuando todo este drama. Y al final, esta secundaria de esta misión de personaje me está gustando bastante. O sea, lo que os digo, por ahí la cosa va bastante bien. Vale, esto ya está, la prisión ha finalizado. Ahora vamos con Boot Hill y ya sabéis de qué va esto. ¡Toma, duelo a muerte! ¡Estás en mi lista! ¡Boom! Vale, la sanación me va a dar un poquito igual porque el tema es soltarle todo lo que podamos y ya está. Así que vamos allá.
Let's go.
Tedious.
Sí, pero ahora clavamos primero esto. Ahí está, volvemos a reventar todo desde el aire. Esto va a hacer una explosión en 0, y ahí se viene el final de los pececitos y del enemigo. Así que boom, 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 todo fuera. Pues ya está, fin de la batalla. Ha sido fácil, ha sido fácil.
That was the last of them. Thank you for helping me out. This place is heavily guarded, but there's nothing but automatons. Where is the arsenal? Seems like not even those craftsmen know where the arsenal is. At this rate, we won't find anything. And Grandpa might take me away before I can do anything. You're not really here to help me. You're here to stop me, right?
Claro, no puedo quedarme sin hacer nada y ver cómo te metes en problemas. Vamos a decirle eso. Creo que es lo más sensato, ¿eh?
But if you want to stop me, you'll have to prove yourself. You probably think I'm being impulsive and unreasonable, right?
Creo que estás muy obsesionada con las espadas malditas, Julie.
Do I come across?
¿No pensáis lo mismo? Pregunto, chat.
Well, I guess I...
Ahora tienes la oportunidad de justificarte.
Seems like you've met a lot of people who don't tell you the whole story.
Bueno. ¿Por qué no me cuentas toda la historia?
Look. I owe you an explanation. But this isn't the best place to talk. We need to find somewhere else. Let me be clear though. I'm still pretty riled up. This is just a temporary break. I already told you about Guyan. The sword that was returned during the ceremony. It's a cursed sword with a helioblast inside. And Hong Guang, the swordsmith who forged it, is my father. I rarely mention his name to anyone other than Grandpa. Maybe, like you said, I've been avoiding having to talk about him. But as long as my mission to hunt down cursed swords continues, it's impossible to avoid the topic forever. For some reason, I feel like I can open up to you. Honestly, I don't remember much about him. All I know is that the Pyrogyre Forge used to be a bustling place, with people from all over coming to get one of his swords. They called him the greatest master craftsman since Yingxing. I didn't catch all the details, but I do remember seeing him forge those amazing swords while the visitors watched with smiles on their faces. I used to believe that craftsmen brought happiness to others. The swords crafted by the Pyrogyre Forge are famed across the stars. They possess exceptional sharpness and invincibility. With these legendary weapons, even ordinary people can become skilled warriors, capable of overcoming the most formidable opponents. But then, he became obsessed with becoming a famed swordsmith and started crossing all sorts of lines. He forged cursed swords that should never exist. And all those people who desired those twisted swords started flooding into the palace. However, just like Grandpa said. Those who excel with the sword will eventually suffer by it. The palace was overrun with visitors from afar. Some left empty-handed. Others got swords that didn't fulfill their desires. And some even resorted to stealing. And in the midst of all the chaos my father created, he ended up being stabbed by one of the swords he forged. It was so sudden and unexpected.
Vale.
I was frozen in place, unable to move. It was only when my mother pushed me away from the deadly swing of the cursed sword that I managed to escape. I don't remember much after that, except for the pounding of my heart and the sound of my own gasps of breath. I could hear the smiths in the pyrogyre forge shouting, "Run away, Yunli!" And the screams of agony. My tears wouldn't stop. And I couldn't see anything. I kept gasping for air until I collapsed in a pool of blood.
Madre mía.
General Huayan hadn't arrived in time.
Es bastante tocho, ¿eh?
I probably wouldn't be here talking to you now. After that, General Huayan took me in and treated me like his own granddaughter. To me, he is 100 times better than my sinful father. He taught me forging and swordsmanship. Hong Guang paid for his sins, but his troubled legacy must not go unchecked. According to the records, he forged a total of 1,382 Heliobus cursed swords, and 182 of them had unique designs. When I joined the Pyrogyre Forge for training, I made a vow to hunt down all those cursed swords. So far, I found 312 of them, and Guyun will be my 313th. Like all the other cursed swords, I'll separate it from the Heliobus. Then, I'll melt it down and make it part of the Blade of Forged Remnants. I've said my piece now. Even though it'll be tough for Grandpa, I still have to melt down the sword.
Pero la delegación la llama la espada de los héroes.
Those travelers who came seeking Hong Guang's swords all came in the name of justice and honor. Most of those so-called great heroes were heartless killers. They are only called heroes because they won. Many of the cursed swords I've destroyed had honorable and grand names too. A legendary sword and a butcher's knife are often just different ways of describing the same thing. Somehow, after talking to you, I feel like I've cooled off a bit. Well, I'll have an honest conversation with Grandpa tomorrow. And I won't take any action against Guyun until he gives me his reasons.
No olvides disculparte con el general Huayan.
Yeah. I shouldn't have done that in a public place. Anyway, thank you. We'll catch up tomorrow.
I should go back to the Palace of Astrum and tell General Huayan what happened at the Artisanship Commission.
Vale, pues volvamos al palacio. Como podéis estar observando, estamos aquí haciendo un poquito lo que es la típica misión en la que nos están contando una historia que está súper interesante. Y la verdad que sirve muy bien un poquito para conocer más de cerca, ¿no?, a nuestro amiguito Huayan y a Yunlin. Así que estoy encantadísimo, ¿eh? Me está gustando mucho, de verdad, lo digo. Tremendo. Explícale la situación. Vamos a ver qué pasa.
Sorry for all this trouble. Yunli told you quite a bit. Now it's time for this old man to tell my side of the story. Han Guang was my beloved disciple. A rare genius not seen in the Pyrogyre Forge since Yingxing. However, talent can sometimes be a curse. He had an unusual fervor for forging, and he dreamed of forging a sword with self-awareness that surpassed that of humans. He believed it would make warriors invincible without any training. According to him, while weapons of mass destruction like Zhu Ming flames and alchemical arrows can destroy many enemies, true victory lies with soldiers who fearlessly fight, ready to lay their lives on the line. Usually, Xianzhou swordsmiths infuse a basic level of awareness into their swords to make them easier to wield. But even then, soldiers need to experience countless battles to overcome fear and sharpen their instincts. So...
Vale. Se le ocurrió usar Heliobus para absorber las emociones. Te he pillado.
Infusing Heliobi into swords, he managed to forge weapons that could grant their wielders strength and valor, and even make decisions for them. However, weapons are different from regular tools. They are meant to kill, plain and simple. After countless battles, all the anger, fear, and bloodlust are soaked up by the Heliobi within the swords. The soldiers wielding them not only gain strength, but they also become consumed by the malice, turning them into puppets possessed by the swords. No matter how noble Han Guan's intentions were, those weapons, soaked in blood, turned into cursed swords eventually. Later, Outworlders got wind of what he was doing and encouraged him to keep forging cursed swords. They came up with all sorts of reasons, from taking back their kingdoms to slaying demons. And you know what happened next. That massacre took her parents' lives, and the lives of many craftsmen in the Pyrogyre Forge. Yunli managed to survive, but she couldn't escape the horrors of that day.
Yunli planea hablar contigo mañana.
I thought this sword could be an opportunity. I wanted to tell her that her father wasn't all evil, that even the man she resents so much managed to forge a true sword of heroes. I also wanted to find a chance to tell her about the history and origin of this sword, but not during the ceremony. As you saw, it wasn't a good time. I've instructed the Artisanship Commission to keep the sword safe in the arsenal. If you have any doubts, feel free to ask the people involved.
Dar instrucciones. Vamos a... Vamos a instruccionar al maestro Gongshu. Perdóname la voz, la tengo cascadísima, ¿eh? No sé de qué, bros. Ya se calmó. Vale. Vale, entiendo que esto ya está.
Since my granddaughter mentioned talking to me tomorrow, I'll be waiting for her. By the way, you watched over her for quite some time. You must be exhausted, aren't you?
Una linda chica como ella nunca me cansa.
I'll be counting on you then.
Time to go back and find that class skipping March 7th.
Vale. Vale, pues parece que tenemos que salir fuera, así que let's go. Y a ver qué pasa ahora. Vale. Vale, ¿pasa algo? ¿Sospechas de mí? ¿Qué me estás contando, tío? El pavo este es rayado, ¿eh? ¿Cómo vas a sospechar de mí? Vale, preguntas rutinarias, vaya, ojo. No, no, no sé yo, ¿eh? No, no me mola, no me mola. Vale. Vamos a ver. Tenemos que venir aquí de nuevo, así que vamos allá. Mirad quién está aquí.
Right. Everyone is here. It's time for questioning.
Yun Lee. I'm sure you understand why the official called you here, right?
Yeah. But I didn't steal the sword.
Yo puedo confirmar
Now
eso.
Is not the time to use your reputation like that. If we don't recover the sword, we will be breaking our promise to the Lawfu and betraying the delegation. We're counting on you to find the truth, Official Daha.
Yes. Vaya.
My duty to thoroughly investigate the case. Even though Yun Lee is firm in her words, we can't just rely on her testimony.
After everything, the sword still got stolen. They should have given it to me from the beginning.
Guarda silencio mejor.
A ver qué nos
dice.
Miss Yun Lee is the main suspect. First, during the sword gifting ceremony, Yun Lee openly expressed her intention to steal the sword. She even mentioned it multiple times. After the ceremony, she broke into the Artisanship Commission and destroyed automatons in an attempt to get the sword. Am I right?
That's true.
The Realm Keeping Commission inspected the arsenal where Gu Yun was stored, and there were no signs of forced entry through the doors or windows. The only possible entrance or exit was a small window gap, just a few inches wide.
Ah, como un misterioso asesinato en una habitación cerrada.
Hey, hey! It's just a theft. The box containing Gu Yun was opened and the sword went missing. But none of the other swords in the room were touched. Which means...
El sospechoso conocía la caja y la espada.
Well, I do know about the box and the cursed sword.
Exactly. The suspect had a clear motive and took only Gu Yun. So, besides the ceremony participants, only the delegation members had access to the sword.
¿Podría haber sido yo quien robó la espada?
So, did you steal it?
No lo hice.
Then stop choking around.
I can prove that he came to me after leaving the Artisanship Commission, so he couldn't have stolen the sword.
Gracias.
Put it simply,
me ha hecho gracia porque era en plan de... Es evidente, ¿no?
Not everyone who might want the sword has seen it. So, the only remaining suspect is Miss Yun Lee.
Fair enough.
So...
I didn't steal the sword.
Well, when you've eliminated the impossible, whatever remains, however improbable, must be the truth.
No. Esta no es la única posibilidad.
If you want to prove me wrong, you better come up with some solid evidence.
Let me gather my thoughts. I need to help Yun Lee clear her name.
Vale. hay que hablar con los testigos, así que vamos a ello.
Yunli says she didn't steal the sword, and I am willing to believe her. But I know well that Yunli can be impulsive. So if she did steal the sword on a whim, I won't show her any favors. You were with Yunli yesterday, young man. So you have the chance to prove her innocence. Is there anything you need to ask me?
No tengo más preguntas.
I'm counting on you, then.
Cuenta conmigo. Vale, parece que aquí va a haber un juicio o algo. Ojo, tenemos el testimonio de Huayan. Vamos a hablar con el maestro Gongshu.
Sí, recibí tu mensaje.
De verdad, me estoy quedando pilladísimo, pero me duele un montón la garganta. Madre mía. No sé qué me pasa, bros.
No sé nada más. Así que preguntar más preguntas no ayudará, me temo. As the master artisan of the Artisanship Commission, I've got to clarify something. Even though the sword was stolen, this commission is still highly secure. Wait, no. I just remembered. My precious Arumatons were smashed.
Vale, aquí tenemos otro testimonio. Algo me dice que por aquí vamos a tener que ver un poquito lo que está pasando realmente. Y esto me suele siempre molar. Yunli no cuenta. Vamos a ver ahí a Dahao. ¡Ey, Dahao!
If you found any clues.
Quisiera hablar de nuevo con los demás. Vale. ¡Pavo! Necesito hablar contigo.
Could have thought that the Mieka Kifesa would be stolen. Regardless, we've accomplished our mission. And now it's the Cienjo's problem. By the way, why did that girl?
Porque está maldita, o sea, es que me hace gracia.
It's quite upsetting. That's enough, young man. Let me get something straight. On Kaluvala, this sword has always been highly revered. The first master of the Mieka Kifesa slew countless demons and then passed it down to a line of wise monarchs. The monarchs would heed the guidance of the hero spirits within the sword and gain insight into defeating their enemies.
No sería la voz de Helios.
What is Helio?
Este no sabe.
Never mind. The point is that the Mieka Kifesa did help the ancestors of Kaluvala build a strong foundation. It's definitely not a cursed sword.
Vale, aquí tenemos otra de las declaraciones. Así que nada, vamos a hablar con Yunli.
I don't want to make things difficult for official Dahao. Let's do this his way and prove my innocence. If I can find that cursed sword, I can prove my innocence right away.
Eso sería muy conveniente.
Well, don't blame me if I find it first and melt it down. There's something else bothering me. Why would the thief take the sword, but leave the case behind? Did they melt down the sword like I wanted to?
¿De verdad es tan extraño?
I mean, carrying around the sword like that would be pretty conspicuous. Wouldn't a thief prefer to take the case as well?
Vale. Vamos a ver. Nos falta una declaración. ¿Pero de quién? Vale. Vamos a abrir la estrecha de espada, lo siento. Ver de cerca las cosas rojas de la parte interior de estuche. ¿De qué me suena esto? De Argenti.
Why is this flower petal inside the case? So the thief to...
Yo creo que tengo mi teoría y es que por aquí está el amigo, así que vamos allá. Vamos a hablar con Dajao. ¡Ey, Dajao! Estoy completamente seguro de que Yunli no robó la espada.
I'm not sure if I can convince Mr. Dahao.
100% sure. Fine. Let me go through my reasoning again, and you can interrupt if anything feels off. Throughout the entire incident, there was only one suspect who broke into the Artisanship Commission, and that was Miss Yun Li.
Mostrémosla, a ver, a lo largo de eso, que escabulló de la comisión de TV, se puede salir de Yun Li. Mostra prueba.
On second thought, maybe...
Take your time. Throughout the entire incident, there was only one suspect who broke into the artisanship.
Yeah, on second thought.
Take your time.
Le da al...
Throughout the entire incident, there was only one suspect who broke into the artisanship.
On second thought.
Take your time. Throughout the entire... Miss Yunli caused a ruckus at the Artisanship Commission trying to take away Gu Yun. But you stopped her in her tracks.
On second thought.
Take your time. Miss Yunli caused a ruckus at the Artisanship Commission trying to...
On second thought.
Take your time. My reason... Miss Yunli caused a ruckus at the Artisanship Commission.
On second thought.
Take your time. Miss Yunli caused a ruckus at the... After bidding farewell to you, Yunli pretended to leave, but
no,
snuck
esto,
into
la prueba es el de...
and stole Gu Yun. Wait, you messaged Master Gongshu?
Vale, eso sí que es una prueba sólida, ¿no?
It only proves the sword wasn't stolen up to that point.
Ay.
I didn't do it.
After bidding farewell to you, Yunli pretended we haven't found any other suspects or evidence.
I carefully examined the lock of the sword case, and there were no signs of tampering or damage.
What does that mean?
Significa que el estuche nunca estuvo cerrado.
As to why the case was never locked in the first place, only the people who delivered it to the Artisanship Commission would know. Plus, I found something else inside the case. Which piece of evidence should I use to further convince?
Obviamente,
we haven't found any other suspects or evidence.
El pétalo de rosa de Argentina.
I found this in the crevice at the bottom of the case.
A rose petal? Huh. I must have missed it during the search. Why was there a petal inside the case?
I don't know. But I do know that wherever that Knight of Beauty goes, he always leaves behind a trail of rose petals that's almost impossible to clean up.
My thoughts are a mess. Let me sort them out. The sword case was never locked, which is evidence that only someone who delivered the sword could have done that. And the rose petal was probably left behind by that Knight of Beauty. But how did he manage to take the sword from the Artisanship Commission? Why did he steal it after returning it here? And why would he leave that petal in the case?
¿Cómo quieres que lo sepa?
I know. Gu Yun flew out of the case on its own. The Knight of Beauty only unlocked the box to aid its escape.
Don't be ridiculous. How can a sword escape from a case on its own?
Hmm. You've never seen a flying sword before?
I've only heard about the Mieka Kifeisa being able to fly in legends. But even if it could fly, why would the Knight of Beauty do this?
Like I said, the sword contains a heliobus. Argenti must have been under the control of the sword. Maybe he was under its control even before you arrived on the Lofu.
Official Dahao, where can we find that knight?
Let me see. The docking location of Argenti's ship, the one and only.
Let's go. We've got to find Argenti before that sword completely takes over his mind.
Vale. Pues parece que toca venir para acá, así que se viene lo bueno. ¿Qué queréis que os diga? Yo creo que aquí va a haber un combate que está bastante, bastante claro, ¿no? Y como siempre, mi consejo, antes de un combatazo, en este caso ya sabéis contra qué crack nos toca pelear, vamos a ir sobre seguro, vamos a buscar algo que realmente le pueda hacer un poquito de daño. Así que vamos a venir un momentito aquí, vamos a venir al tema de el... No, me lo voy a gestionar más fácil por aquí, ¿no? Formación. Lo siento, Budhill, eres un crack, eres un fenómeno, pero ahora necesitamos a alguien que haga daño en área. Así que aquí está la crack de la nihilidad. Bien, ahora venimos por aquí, vamos un momentito a personajes un momentito, ¿vale? A ver qué pasa y luego os digo. Vamos a ver si tengo algo para mejorar de rastros. No, esto está a full, está a tope, vale, bien. El cono tiene 80, está 80. Artefactos va bastante, bastante bien. Un momentito. No, ninguna así guapa de las. Pues no. Vale, pues nada, la vamos a dejar así. Ok, ok, ok. A ver, cosas importantes, ¿vale? En este caso. Vamos a prepararnos. Yo creo que esto va a ser como un boss, así que vamos a darnos un poquito de mejora, margen de mejora. Así que venimos por aquí. Y lo primero de todo, algo que nos aumente la vida, ¿vale? Por ejemplo, un heladito de estos. Ahí está, usar. Vale. Y ahora vamos a hacer algo que nos dé un poquito de ataque. Ahí está. Y vamos a ver qué pasa, porque lo que os digo, esto tiene pinta de Argenti. Y ahí está. El caballero de la belleza, el caballero de las rosas. Argenti, bros. Y está con una silla esperándonos. Esto va a ser un combate. En un rincón de Dársena se encuentra con un caballero con armadura. Mejor dicho, él no se encuentra. Y aquí está Yun Lin. Día 15 del mes X, bueno.
I've been waiting for you here for quite a while.
Hey, Argenti. ¿Qué estás haciendo, brother? ¿Qué estás haciendo?
You're the one who stole Guyun, right? Hand it over. You have no idea how dangerous that cursed sword is.
Dangerous? In my humble opinion, the real danger is always the hand wielding the weapon.
¿Por qué quieres robar la Guyun?
Please allow me to correct your statement. I never attempted to steal this weapon. As a driller's knight, I've sworn to live in poverty and possess only what is necessary.
Vale.
What? What do you mean?
I agreed to assist Master Guyun in its escape from the Xianzhou. As the person who pulled it from the stone monument, captivated by its beauty, I must not let it down. I couldn't stay in the arsenal to convince the craftsmen, nor did I want to take the sword like a thief. That's why I left behind a small piece of evidence that pointed to my identity in the hope of an open and honest conversation with you.
Whatever your reasons are, you're planning to take the cursed sword away from the Xianzhou. Hand it over to me.
Back then, it was the beauty of Master Guyun that impressed me. So I willingly embarked on the journey to return the sword. But unfortunately, Master Guyun's homeland is no longer the ideal place for it to return to. As a knight of beauty, I must not abandon it halfway.
Oh no. He's completely captivated by the power of that cursed sword.
¿Cómo podemos hacerlo volver en sí? El Heliobús lo está controlando. Vale, bate galáctico, ¿no?
No, I am touched by Master Guyun's flawless beauty. To be honest, I'm confused why none of you can understand this sword. This is quite heartrending. I've already made up my mind to take Master Guyun away from the Xianzhou.
That cursed sword has messed with your ability to think. But I'll break you free from its grip. I'll shatter its illusion. And the sword itself.
Madre mía.
Fair lady, If you're intent on taking away this person,
pues nada, parece que toca enfrentarnos a la gente.
Please engage me with a fair duel according to knightly etiquette. As a representative of this duel, I, Argenti, challenge you.
Pues os voy a decir una cosa, no me esperaba para nada esto, ¿eh? Me estáis poniendo en el chat, se veía venir. Pues no, yo hasta que no he visto a Rosa no me imaginaba que ibas a pelear contra Argenti. Vale, si gana él, permitimos que abandone el Xianzu. Si le vencemos, aceptará la derrota y les dará al maestro Guyun, que es la espada.
Do you accept my challenge, Miss Yunli?
Fine. Let's see whose desire is stronger. Your desire to take it away, or my desire to hunt down all cursed swords. Show me what you've got.
Pues se viene combatito, chavales. ¿Qué queréis, tío? Ya sabéis cómo va esto. Argenti ataca bastante fuerte, así que nosotros vamos a buscar lo primero de todo, la ruptura, para ir haciendo daño. Y pues bueno, con esto lo tenemos fácil. ¡Oh! Ahí está. Vale, arma libre, no se fea. Nada. Vale, mete barrera, ojo.
Are made to be broken.
¿Metes barrera? Pues yo rompo barrera.
Stand down.
Vale, cargamos esto. Ya sabéis cómo va a ir. Los golpeteos van rápidos, van sencillos. Cargamos la habilidad. Venimos por aquí y vamos a pegarle de 75 y literalmente a 67. Le reventamos una, le reventamos otra. Nos da barrera a nosotros. Y ahora pues podemos continuar un poquito con ráfagas. Ahí está. Vale, golpeamos. Vamos a buscar quitarle un poquito la barrera a lo que sigue. La barrera es la clave en este combate, así que nosotros vamos a ataques normales para ir quitándole. Vale, de nuevo pone aquí sus amiguitos. ¡Oh, vaya! Esto es lo que más le quita. Vale, voy a tirar la ráfaga por aquí. Ahí está, pum, esto le quita bastante. Ahora por aquí, pues, vamos con un golpe tranquilito y ¡bomba! Rompemos electrocución, esto explota, nos da barrera. Y ahora, pues, vamos a tirar un poquito de cura para curarnos a full. E intentar que no nos hagan tanto daño. De momento tenemos a dos personajes bastante fuerte ahora mismo. Él se intenta chetar, pero nosotros tenemos todavía el último de nuestros ataques, que básicamente se quita un poquito todo esto. Le dejamos a 20, atacamos normal, 18. Le bajamos a 16. Lo que os digo, esta primera fase es bastante, bastante sencilla. La siguiente vamos a ir a tope. Vale. Pone más barreras, que haga lo que quiera. Ya sabéis cómo va esto. Uno por aquí, ruptura. Y se pone así. Siguiente fase. Vale, alma libre. Nosotros venimos y le vamos a decir que se prepare porque se vienen muchos cortes. Y le bajamos 88 de un golpe, le reventamos, le hacemos ruptura, nos ponemos barrera y esto pues ya está. Volvemos. Rafaguita por ahí, le bajamos 76. Ya sabéis de qué va esto, 75. Volvemos a golpear cargando con nuestro bate galáctico. Y ahora, pues por aquí, un ataque normal para pasar un poquito del rollo. Ahí está, nos quitamos la barrerita, el bien doble, muy bien. Y nosotros ahora aprovechamos, cargamos esto, preparamos toda la transición en ciernes. Y de paso tiramos un poquito de sueño de flores efímeras para reventarle esa bonita barrera. Le bajamos a 20 y yo creo que este amigo va a caer derrotado en 0, ahí está, reventadito el Argenti, bros. GG well played. Es que está muy roto.
I've lost. According to the rules of a knight's duel, I should keep my promise and hand over the sword to you. But before I do that, I hope that you, as the winner, might have the mercy and listen to Master Guyan's past experiences.
This sword has been cursed since the day it was forged. Place it in front of me, and let me destroy it.
Do what she says, knight.
But...
You've done so much for me already. It's time for me to face her alone.
Vale. Argenti extiende la antigua espada. Ante la mirada de todos, la espada se yergue lentamente.
I'm weary of fighting. I just want to share my past with you. To explain why I wanted to escape. After that, I'll leave my destiny in your hands. Are you afraid to witness my past, little girl?
Afraid?
Though you do have a different aura from other cursed swords. But you're just trying to use my curiosity to lure me in.
Well, you know best that a single touch won't snatch away anyone's sanity.
Vale.
Fine. Show me your past.
Ahora lo miro. Vamos a hablar con la espada y averiguar por qué huyó Guyun.
It's already impossible to contact the main Cloud Knight forces. What awaits me will be a long and lonely war.
Follow me.
Is this your memory?
¡Hala! ¿Y esto? Oh, mola, ¿no?
It's so cold here. I didn't feel it when I was in the thick of battle, but now it's freezing me to the bone. You're indeed a masterpiece from the Xianzhou Juming. If you hadn't taken control of my body, I probably would have been decapitated in that fight.
Quiet, and stay alert. Boris and the wolf troopers never give up the hunt.
Hey, just relax a bit. It's been over 300 days since we were both stranded on this planet. The transmitter never rings, so I guess we can't count on that anymore. The people on this planet still use beasts to pull their carts. Obviously, there's no way they can help us fix the star skiff. Looks like we're stranded on this forsaken planet for the rest of our lives.
The rest of a Xianzhou native's life could be terribly long. Are you feeling any desperation? All by yourself in this hostile world?
Yeah, a bit. Perhaps.
When things get too rough for you to handle, just leave everything to me. No need to carry the weight of the world on your shoulders.
Yeah, sure. If I really can't handle things anymore, I'll leave my body to you. But now is not that time.
Do you really think you can oppose an entire Borsan army with your limited skills? What are you holding out for?
It's true that I'm stranded here. It seems like that Borisan pack is in the same boat. By the way, Guyun, do you know what a seed is? A seed may seem insignificant, but with careful cultivation and time, it can grow into a huge, unwavering tree. You said that the rest of a Xianzhou native's life could be terribly long. You're right. That's why I intend to plant a seed named Resistance here. And nurture it for the rest of my life. I want to show the people of this land how to defend themselves against those monsters. I can already see the seed in the eyes of those people.
You really think you can do it? Why not just give me control, and we can revel in the bloodbath together?
What was the memory I just saw?
It was a memory of me and a Cloud Knight, stranded on an unfamiliar planet. We crash-landed on a planet occupied by Borisan. Just two of us.
I can feel that it was a lonely war.
Vamos a seguir la espada.
Young people in the village.
They died.
My mia.
They died for you. They died because of your big promises. promising them a life free from the Borisen. I tasted their despair before death. They didn't see it coming, and neither will you.
We can't stay here. Let's move on to the next village.
Why? What's the point? You and your sorry excuse for an army have been fighting for over 3 decades, and you haven't won a single battle. What you're sowing is not resistance, but despair. This world is hopeless. It's completely infested with packs of Borisen. You've seen their numbers, and you know their methods. And those commoners you've put your hopes in, they just kneel down and worship the monsters devouring their children and families, calling them their beastmasters. You beheaded one of the beastmasters for their sake, but they turned on you because they were scared of the Borisen taking revenge. You remember all that, right?
I do. I remember my first death. The Borisen cut off my head. But I also remember that if it weren't for a brave youngster who risked his neck to reattach my head and give me a proper burial, I would have disappeared completely. I remember everything the people did for me. They left food at the entrance of my cave, fixed my fur coat, and some even joined my resistance. The rest of the Xianzhou native's life is still terribly long. There will be new youngsters who will stand beside me in battle. Time is on our side.
You said it was a lonely war. No. It wasn't a war filled with loneliness, but with despair. So much despair that I don't want to ever taste it again.
Bueno, pues nada. Como siempre, lo que os digo, las misiones estas a mí me flipan. Esta está siendo muy divertida. El tema de Yun-Li me interesa bastante, así que flipando me hallo.
Where are you going, Your Highness?
I'm returning to my homeland, a distant place beyond the sky. I'm not coming back.
But what should we do with you gone? What if those wolf demons show up again?
They won't, my child. You've wiped out the last of them. But before I go, I need you to do one thing for me. Even though the wolf demons are gone, new monsters will appear in this world. Soon, a demon will appear, donning golden branches and knowing only bloodshed. However, fear not, my children. I'm entrusting you with this sword that's been with me in countless battles. Use the skills I've taught you over the years, and you'll surely defeat that last demon. But that's not all. I need you to construct a stone monument for me. It must be large and sturdy enough to seal the remains of that demon forever. This is a debt you owe me, and you must fulfill it. Do you understand?
You lied to them. And you lied to me, too.
Vaya.
Oh?
You promised that you'd give your body to me when you couldn't handle things anymore.
Well, this Xianzhou native's life has finally come to an end, my old friend. How about one last chance for revenge? Come and bid me farewell for the final time.
He had long since come to some understanding. I could sense a mix of intricate emotions flowing out. It wasn't bloodlust, or anger, or fear. What he had left for you was hope.
They've learned how to fight monsters. But there's still one last monster lingering in the world. Kill it, my old friend. He left me there without ever looking back.
Vale.
Thank you, my old friend. And Heliobi can taste human emotions. How do my emotions taste? My old friend.
A hint of bitter compassion. And a touch of scalding courage. Your heart's deepest desire is to end war once and for all. Now, the war is finally over. Can you hear? Even though you can't hear me anymore, my old friend, I'll do everything I can to bring an end to all conflicts in this world.
So, this is the past of the Kalevalan people's Sword of Heroes? You helped the people of that world bring an end to war?
No, I did not. I am a weapon, and I only became the cause of more conflicts. Countless monarchs of Kalevala saw me as a symbol of kingship endowed by nature. And they waged wars in order to possess me. I grew tired of their wicked intentions. I didn't want to kill for anyone anymore. So I returned to the stone monument where my master was buried. And since then, no one was able to remove me from it.
But you allowed Argenti to take you away?
Because even after all this time, I still wanted my master to come home.
Bueno, pues parece que esto sigue. Me ha gustado bastante el tema de los recuerdos. Entender esta historia, lo que decís vosotros, es muy interesante. Al final, aquí en el juego siempre nos traen estas sorpresas y está bastante bien.
Durante la ceremonia de la espada, I felt anguish when I learned that I would be handed over to the most skilled swordmaster and once again become a tool for killing. My master had engraved his deepest desire into my blade. End war. As a weapon, my purpose was predetermined from the start. I had to become a deadly sword that would relentlessly hack and kill. But once I fulfilled my mission, would I have the right to choose my own destiny like he did? So, I asked the Knight of Beauty to help me break free from this never-ending cycle of bloodshed.
These thousands of years have naturally turned into memories of mine. I think I understand the beauty the knight was talking about now.
I don't want to be a sword that brings death. My war ended long ago. The years spent as a tombstone were my finest.
I've told you everything about my experience with Master Guion on Kalevala. And now, I'm sure that Miss Yun Li is as moved by the sword's flawless beauty as I was back then.
Even though I had heard the legends of this sword from the delegation, delving into its memories was still fascinating.
Vale.
Yun Li, I trust Gu Yin's
experience has changed your mind. No tenía ni idea de que esta espada tuviera semejante pasado.
It wasn't until I held Guyan in my hands that I could sense its thoughts and unspoken words. I always thought a cursed sword infused with a Heliobus would only bring rage and slaughter. I never thought someone could leave behind the desire to end war, and even change the nature of the cursed sword. My position was too extreme. Guyan is truly a sword of heroes. I apologize to all of you for my behavior. I'm sorry.
Pues nada.
Now that we've proven Miss Yun Li's innocence and found the sword, should we now return it to the arsenal?
No. I'm still going to melt down this sword.
Vale. Esto tiene pinta de que es el final de la historia, ¿eh? ¡Oh, Yun Li! A ver, creo que es una historia que realmente te presenta muy bien al nuevo personaje.
I can sense that you're tired of being a sword, constantly serving new masters and fighting battles you no longer want to be part of.
But being a sword is my destiny. I'm doomed to serve some master and fight battles endlessly. Can the wind choose to stop blowing? Can a cloud choose to stop drifting? No. It's the same for me. A creation with a predetermined destiny.
That's not true, Guyan. That nameless swordmaster shaped his own destiny. So you can too.
I just can't picture my destiny being anything other than that of a sword.
Do you remember when you stood alone in front of the swordmaster's stone monument? People admired you because you carried the memories of the hero. You are no longer a sword. You
vale.
Are a memorial.
Me está gustando later, mucho lo que veo, ¿eh?
As I became worn and weathered, the gentle wind.
Es que al final es lo que os digo, o sea, con toda esta actualización hemos vivido una aventura yo creo que muy guapa. Teníamos también esto que siempre tengo que decirlo, me gusta mucho el cómo van vinculando este tipo de cosas, este tipo de historias. Y además lo que os digo, Yun Li es un personaje que os lo pondré al principio del vídeo, pero me la he sacado. No lo he hecho en el directo de hoy, ¿vale? Lo hice el otro día grabando y tal. Y dije, ostras, pues para cuando haga la misión, lo haré, que al final hice el evento primero. Entonces, como siempre, las cosas cambian de planes. Algo diferente, ojo.
My granddaughter has always been stubborn. Are you really sure about this, Yun Li?
What do you all think?
Si es lo que quieres, yo te apoyo.
Fulfilling Master Guyan's wishes is the reason I came to the Xianzhou. With the Driller's blessing, you could turn Master Guyan into a plow. But as long as it fulfills his wish to end war, I support it fully.
Then, I'll leave it to you.
Por último, se dirigen a la armería de la pentada comisión de artesanía para usar el horno de forjado. Y ahí está.
The honor is mine. Thank you, Yun Li.
Okay, ha estado muy guapa la quest, tengo que decirlo. Me ha parecido una misión muy bonita. Estamos en una zona segura. Y dice, ¿por qué la cara larga, mi niña? ¿Te estás arrepintiendo?
You were completely determined when melting down the sword. So, why the sudden change of heart?
Grandpa, I melted down the prize for the war dance. How are you going to explain this to the lawful?
Oh, am I hearing right? This little girl is worried about her grandpa. Didn't see that coming.
Él va a la suya.
If only I talked to you from the beginning, Grandpa. Maybe things wouldn't have escalated like this. But at least Guyan got what it wanted. I have no regrets there.
When it comes to swords, you and your father are cut from the same cloth. So, are you planning to continue melting down the rest of Hong Guang's swords?
Yeah. Guyan is unique. But the other cursed swords are still too dangerous for anyone to handle. But maybe I'll try to be more patient next time.
Be more patient. Well said. Remember what you learned today. Because there will be many more situations in the future that will require you to be more patient.
Understood. But what about the prize?
Well, ever since you showed up at the ceremony, I had a hunch. So I prepared another sword as a backup plan. And don't worry, this one has nothing to do with Heliobai.
That's perfect.
By the way, the ambassador from Kalevala and that knight went to Aurum Alley. They're looking for a spot to honor the hero. Why don't we go take a look together?
¡Vamos! Entonces ahora entiendo que tenemos que venir. Estaba leyendo lo que estáis poniendo. Me ha gustado mucho lo de la conmemoración, todo lo que se ha ido haciendo. Pero realmente estoy igual que vosotros. O sea, ¿cómo van a hacer el tema de lo del torneo y demás, eh? Me lo pregunto muchísimo porque, claro, realmente se supone que todo esto va a continuar en la siguiente versión. Y ahí veremos incluso lo de Huley. Así que la cosa está bastante guay. Aquí está Argenti y el otro, así que vamos a ver. ¿Qué le trae por aquí?
My granddaughter was inspired by the heroic legends told by the Mieka Kibesa.
So, yo soy feliz con estas misiones. De verdad lo digo, o sea, me gustan bastante. Hay gente en el directo. Hoy, ¿qué es este brote dorado?
I come from a long line of Kalevalan monument keepers. For generations, my family has guarded the stone monument left behind by the... Over the centuries, a golden tree sprouted from under the monument. And its branches have... Never withered. We Kalevalans see it as proof of the hero's existence.
Vale.
Before leaving Kalevala, I took a branch from that golden tree, hoping to plant it here to represent the hero returning to his homeland.
That sounds good. We Xianzhou people don't make coffins or set up memorials, so I'm sure he would be happy to rest here where life is bustling.
The hero had asked our ancestors to carve something into the monument. So I made a copy of it too. While the inscription is pretty worn with age, perhaps you can still make out some of it.
I have drifted far from my homeland and am on the brink of death. Yet, I take solace in having honorably fulfilled my duties. Should you feel compassion for me, kind traveler, please take a handful of soil hence and bring it back to the lawful. Mr. Pavo, I wonder if that hero ever left a name in your history.
I apologize, but the hero's epic battles happened long ago, and he did not leave any name for us to call him. but in our mythology, he came from the heavens, and so we call him the Cloud Knight.
Welcome home, Cloud Knight.
Now, you can also rest here, Guyan.
Pues ahora sí, está completado. ¿Qué queréis que os diga? Me ha parecido muy, muy bonito lo que hemos podido ver. Así que, como siempre, me han sorprendido bastante con el hecho de esta misión. Creo que ha sido de las más interesantes en mucho tiempo de estas de personaje, ya que realmente una de las cosas que más me ha gustado, ¿no?, es el hecho de que hemos podido disfrutarla de una manera breve, una manera que, lo que os digo, en horita y media te la quitas, pero guau, es que qué historia más guapa. O sea, me ha molado mucho, ¿vale? Vale que el rollo del Lufou siempre creo que es de los que más me han llamado la atención, ¿vale? Pero está bastante, bastante interesante todo lo que estamos viendo por aquí. Así que, como podéis ver, ahora básicamente lo que tenemos aquí es otro eventito de estos chulos para participar con más basuritas de estas, más cubos de basura que están muy top. Y bueno, lo veremos también, ¿no? Tenemos un nuevo personaje del cual podemos hacer la demostración y demás, Yao Qiu. Y bueno, pues lo que os digo, nueva etapa de pura ficción, un montón de cositas para ir haciendo y disfrutar de la aventura en una actualización que desde luego a mí me ha dejado loquísimo. Pero que, como ya sabéis, también importante en misiones, siguen apareciendo cositas. Aquí tenemos algunas cosas como lo de nuevos y viejos amigos, ¿vale? Parece que esto es nuevo, ¿no? Temporal. Vale, esto será lo del evento, creo yo, ¿no? Digo yo. Sí, esto tiene pinta de que es lo del evento. Bueno, pero aquí ya veis que hay bastantes cositas y en ramificaciones de destino siguen habiendo cositas que aparecen por aquí, ¿vale? Así que vamos a ver un poquito. Porque en la torre aquí está la investigación de esto, ferocidad animal y narraciones extraordinarias. Lo que os digo, cositas habidas y por haber, siempre es lo divertido de esto. Que por más que pensemos que no lo hemos pasado todo, aquí fijaos que seguimos teniendo cositas interesantes. Nada más que decir, espero que os haya gustado un poquito lo que es esta parte del directo. Vamos ahora, voy a estar un ratito charlando con vosotros y demás, porque me lo estáis pidiendo mucho. Estaba leyendo todo lo que estáis poniendo, pero no he podido un poquito tampoco contestar mucho. Y así pues aprovecho un poquito, ¿no?, y me pongo con vosotros de chill, de tranqui, como queráis llamarlo. ¿Qué puedo decir? Me ha gustado mucho la misión, ha sido top, la verdad. Y bueno, si os ha gustado el vídeo, como siempre, por favor, dejad el buen like, suscribíos al canal si estáis viendo esto en YouTube. Os recomiendo y os leo en comentarios, así que cualquier cosa que me queráis comentar de este juego o otro, pues me lo dejáis en un comentario e intentaré contestaros en la máxima brevedad posible. Si os ha gustado el vídeo, dejad el like. Como siempre, lo que os digo, decidme qué os gustaría ver a continuación con el tema de Honkai, porque tenemos un montón de secundarias todavía interesantes de aquí en Lufou para ir haciendo. Y poco más, en el próximo directo intentaré un poquito, pues eso, hacer secundarias y demás, y el tema del evento. Nada más que deciros, chicos, chicas, espero que os lo hayáis pasado bien también los que estáis aquí en el directo, los que estáis en YouTube, como siempre, un gran abrazo. Soy José Herrero y nos vemos en la próxima. Traza caminos.